She took her stand on the fact that she was a colonel's wife, though she often fought with her husband, the colonel, and scratched his face handsomely on such occasions. Add to this that it was her custom to drink 4 glasses of vodka at lunch, or earlier, and 4 more in the evening, and that she hated Mrs. Antipova to madness. "I've just come in for a minute, mon ange," she panted. "It's no use sitting down, no time. I wanted to let you know what's going on. Simply that the whole town has gone mad over this prince. Our beauties, you know what I mean, are all after him, fishing for him, pulling him about, giving him champagne. You would not believe it, would you now? How on earth you could ever have let him out of the house, I can't understand. Are you aware that he's at Natalia Dmitrievna's at this moment?" "At Natalia Dmitrievna's?" cried Maria Alexandrovna, jumping up. "Why, he was only going to see the governor, and then call in for 1 moment at the Antipova's." "Oh, yes, just for 1 moment, of course. Well, catch him if you can there. That's all I can say. He found the governor out, and went on to Mrs. Antipova's, where he has promised to dine. There Natalia caught him. She is never away from Mrs. Antipova nowadays, and persuaded him to come away with her to lunch. So there's your prince. Catch him if you can."
"But how? Moskalyakov's with him. He promised."
"Moskalyakov, indeed! Why, he's gone, too. And they'll be playing at cards and clearing him out before he knows where he is. And the things Natalia is saying, too, out loud, if you please. She's telling the prince to his face that you have got hold of him with certain views. Vous comprenez?